Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back. I had a question asked me a few weeks ago. Now I'm going to reply to it. Is glutathione good for candida? So what is glutathione? It sounds like some sort of a weird new, like Korean car or something, doesn't it? Glutathione. But glutathione is actually what we call a tripeptide. It's an amino acid that's composed of three aminos, cysteine, glycine, and glutamine, I think it is. Glutamine, glycine, and cysteine. So these three aminos make up glutathione, which is a very powerful amino acid, antioxidant in the body. So it quenches free radicals, so it stops damage or oxygen-induced damage to the body. So oxygen can cause problems for the body, and many other enzymatic processes that occur create actual damage in the body that's countered by antioxidants. So vitamin C, vitamin A, vitamin E, selenium, zinc, these are all antioxidants. But glutathione is one of our most powerful ones. Excuse me. So anything we can do to boost glutathione production is going to help, of course, you know, reduce aging and reduce a lot of potential, you know, pushing us into chronic disease prematurely. We're all going to die, but we want to die healthy and slowly, okay, not quickly, all right, if you get my drift. So how can we improve glutathione? Is it important for candida? It is important for candida. And in fact, glutathione is important for anybody who's got a pulse, who's alive, who wants to stay looking good for at least 5 minutes longer than they are. All right? So if you want to look good, stay good, and be in good health, you've got to reduce the body's ability to have this impact of this damage to the cells. And glutathione will certainly do that. Is it a good supplement? Well, from where I'm sitting, I think you're probably better off having the sulfur amino acids, increase those in the diet in particularly, because these are precursors to building glutathione. So give the body what it needs to build something, and if it's got a reasonably good digestive system, it's going to build plenty of that. So sulfur is a very important thing to have in your diet for that reason, because it boosts up the production of glutathione. So sulfur is contained in most meats, for example, beef, poultry, fish will contain it, nuts and seeds. There are many things that can contain sulfur. So go to Google and type in sulfur containing foods and look at the top four or five. Right? Nuts and seeds, for example, is a good one. So those are certainly things that you're wanting to be put into your diet, absolutely. Also, you probably really want to be looking at the brassicas, because the brassicas also contain thiols or sulfur containing components in them. We look at broccoli, we look at Brussels sprouts. These are also good to boost glutathione production right up. So by having a powerful glutathione response, you're going to minimize the damage caused by SIBO and candida and these kinds of things. Okay, clever to do that. Vitamin C is a very good thing to boost up in your body too, because it's going to take the whack before glutathione takes it. So if you've got a good vitamin C content of the body, you've got less chance of the body having a big requirement for glutathione than if you had low levels of vitamin C. You get my drift? So that's why eating fruit and vegetables is very, very good. And maybe even taking 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C as a supplement here or there. Because people with high vitamin C content in their blood, higher ascorbate, tend to have a lot less problems with free radical damage. And you also notice their skin looks a lot better as they get older, rather than, you know, wrinkly old kind of person. So glutathione, absolutely, I recommend that you look at it, not as a supplement, yes, but probably better off through food sources. Last thing I should tell you about it is there's an enzyme called glutathione peroxidase. Now, this gets boosted up tremendously when we have selenium in our diet. So selenium, especially if you're going to have three or four Brazil nuts per day, chew them well, excuse me, you're going to put 150 micrograms, 200 micrograms into the body extra that you would normally get. So selenium really revs up glutathione peroxidase and can quadruple, you know, tenfold its output in no time when you start putting regular selenium into the diet. So I recommend usually anywhere between 150 up to 300 micrograms of selenium. If you've got cancer, I recommend 400 micrograms of selenium per day. But as I say, Brazil nuts is one of the best sources. Two or three per day will put you in the ballpark. So recap, best foods to eat to boost up glutathione would be the sulfur-containing foods, and they would be also the selenium-rich containing foods, the vitamin C foods. Turmeric is another one that, that tends to have a good effect on glutathione peroxidase, so turmeric. So when peroxidase enzyme is really cranked up and working well, it facilitates a good detoxification in the body, in the liver, with minimal damage. And that's why it's important for you to have good glutathione levels in particular. Thanks for tuning in.